Motivation of this suite of research is to understand vehicle demand and usage, and through understanding those, how we can contribute to better policy to mitigate greenhouse gas emissions and to reduce local criteria pollutant damages. In each of the studies, the main elements were what vehicle is being chosen and driven, what are the attributes of that vehicle, fuel economy and other attributes, what are the pollutants that that vehicle is generating, and what is the cost of driving that vehicle. The co-benefits paper and the household portfolio paper were using what we would call reduced form regression methods to look at relationships between variables in the data. So for the co-benefits paper, we were looking at the relationship between the cost of driving and the number of miles traveled. Mm-hmm. And in the household portfolio paper, we were looking at the effect that changing the kept car fuel economy has on the bought car fuel economy when a two-car household replaces one of its cars. The third part of the project, the dynamic vehicle choice model, was a very different methodology. There we were specifying a model of consumer behavior that included interesting dynamic features like a forward-looking consumer that was taking account of the stream of gasoline costs that it would incur by using the vehicle in the future. The fact that buying and selling a car has transaction frictions. It's, you know, it's costly in non-monetary ways to find a buyer for your car, find the person who's selling the car that you want. So these features were built into the dynamic vehicle choice model. The way that those are solved is just a very different technology than a regression model. In the co-benefits study, the main takeaway that I have out of that is there are a lot of differences across vehicles and across households in terms of the pollutants that are being generated and the potential damages from these pollutants. And again, these are both kind of climate change related, but also local, like health, local criteria pollutant and health related. And that trying to create a policy that deals with both of those at the same time is extremely challenging. For the second paper, the household portfolio paper, I must say that I was somewhat disappointed with the results because they show that this desire for a diverse portfolio of cars in a multi-car household has unfortunate implications for the benefits from, say, a fuel economy standard, which is such an important policy in our you know, climate change mitigation efforts. And unfortunately, this result would lead us to believe that that might be undermined a little bit by consumer preferences. I think it's very challenging to figure out a policy for transportation emissions of the local criteria pollutant variety because there are just so many differences across vehicles, including where they're driven. If you drive a car in Los Angeles, then contributing, you know, carbon monoxide to that environment is much more damaging, and we care a lot more about it than if we were to drive that car in the Sierra Nevadas. So that's a very complicated problem.